Hello everyone. In today's class we are going to talk about the narrative structure of a storytelling. Generally it's nothing but a way of a storytelling. How do we tell a story to people by movie or whatever movie or in a story or in a story book? How do we tell a story? How do we narrate or explain about the story? Generally it's all about. So in filmmaking, they divide the storytelling, way of storytelling in some kind of act structures. The 9 act structures are: Act 1, the opening, setting the scene of the film. So generally the Act 1 stands for the opening or the establishment of what is going on in the story. And the Act 2 is conflict, something bad happens. It's not like something only bad should be happened. It can be anything, some particular event, or it can be anything about the story. And the Act 3 is the audience meet the hero, and the development of the characters happen within this act. So in this Act 3, we can see about the people or the characters which revolves around the story. Who is the protagonist, who is the antagonist, who is the heroine, or what is the conflict, how do these people connect with this conflict, and what are they going to do, what is their character actually stands for. And the Act 4 is the character commits to the course of action. So the characters, how do they commit? That's what I said. How do they commit with the story? How do they connect with the story? And the Act 5, character goes for wrong goal, ending up with protagonist at lowest point in the story. So this could be the before the climax, like the protagonist, who's the hero of the movie, he actually do something and that goes wrong. Because of the antagonist did something. That's a kind of play. Actually, see, generally the movie consists of a protagonist, antagonist. Maybe they include a female character as a heroine, and the supporting actors, actress. These are the people who were actually involved in the story, because the story demands, the play or the film demands such characters should be there in the movie. And the Act 6 is beginning with everything at its worst. The characters start to make the sense of information leading to. So it's nothing but generally the protagonist, the hero, what do we do? He save people. He do all good things. Simply to say, he do all good things. He do show only the positive side of what he is actually going to do. And the Act 7, when new plan of action is developed. Okay, fine, he did something wrong, and then now what he's going to do is he's going to recorrect his mistakes. It happens. What do? He do something against or without his knowledge, he can do anything. But then now he come up with the other plan to reorder the story or the mistakes what he does in this film. Act 8, this act ties up all of those loose ends. Okay, fine. See, generally the way of storytelling, what we do, what we see in our films, are the movie, either the movie complete with the closed end or the open end. Closed end means they'll come to a conclusion. Okay, the hero or the heroine or the antagonist will be die. That's the basic way of telling a story. Okay, he's a villain, he should die. He is not suit for the story, or he's not the suit for the story what the movie actually is, so he should die. So that's how. So they come to a conclusion that the story ends there. And the open-ended movie is what they do is they'll give the climax to the audience. We used to, as an audience, we used to sit and watch a movie on our own perspective, or either what we do is we replace the hero in, we replace the antagonist, sorry, protagonist with us. Maybe we replace them, or we connect the story with our life, our reality, what we actually do in our real life. So what they do is, it's a kind of interesting way of telling a story. They'll give you an open ended. The climax can be anything. You can judge by your own audience. If there are bunch of audience, imagine there are bunch of audience seeing a movie and watching a movie, and what do they do is, everybody has their own idea of how to watch such movies. So for me, I'll make a decision of what should be the climaxes, and the other person who is sitting next to me will have some other perspective, and he has some other ideas of how to finish the story. The story can be anything. We used to discuss with our friends or people who are sitting next to us in theaters or anywhere. Okay, why does he does something? Why he could have done this? He could have done that. If the movie should end like this, it will be awesome. That kind of idea is called as open-ended story. The act 9 ends or closes the story or a film. So the act 9 should be, there should be an end or there should be a stop. Okay, fine. This is the story. This is how it starts. These are the conflicts inside it. And then this is the conclusion. They come to a conclusion of a story or a film, the climax. 3-act structure. General way of 3-act structure. If you want to explain a story to a people, you should divide a story into 3-act structure. By using this 3-act structure theory, you should divide the story. Let's see how it starts. The 3-act structure can work with narrative. Okay, fine. If you are narrating a movie to a friend, how do you narrate a movie? Imagine if a story revolves with 4 friends. Okay, in general, in Tamil movies or South Indian movies, it's the movie start with the opening scene of a village and wide angle and wild opening scene of a village, and they come closer to a guy or the guy who is sitting in the new TV tea stall, and they started talking about why do these people are doing such things. That's how they give an introduction to the people or the protagonist or the guys who is involved in this movie. So that's how it starts. Okay, fine. He is there. He is the one who is doing good things. Or they try to justify the character, give the introduction to the character by saving someone's life or by doing some good things. So we'll blindly have an impact on such characters that he is a good guy. Okay, he save people. He do all good things. He never harm anyone. That's kind of. So where the story starts, how the story is going to happen, what is he going to do, what is his role, who is he, how he is going to solve the conflict. That will be the setup. Setup means act 1. So act 1, introduction, brief introduction of a movie. And the second one is conflict. Obviously, if there is a movie, there should be a conflict. Or that should be a problem. Every story has come up with one or the other way. They'll come up with a story or a conflict or a problem or whatever it can be. How the protagonist and antagonist is going to use this conflict on their own way. Resolution, as usual, climax. Come to a conclusion. It can be a open-ended or closed-ended. Narrative theories. Suggested the story that start with opposing forces in balance. This is distributed by the event setting a series of other events. Along the way, these problems are solved and resolved to the world of fiction. So fictional movies is what it is. How we write the story. We are cooking up a story and we are giving a conflict and we showing them. We need to show them how to end this conflict or how to restore the problem, how they going to handle the problem and what are the hurdles facing while faced by the protagonist while kind of solving this conflict. So these are the characters who was always involved in the way of the storytelling or the story. That if there is a story, there should be a protagonist, there should be an antagonist, there should be a heroine. It's a traditional way of telling a story. So if there is only positive things, it should not be so good, or it should not give you the essence of the storytelling. So it won't be so good. If you are listening a story, it's a kind of way of listening. Some people is telling something good about someone, that's it. You there won't be any ups and downs. The movie will be the flat line. So villains, the hero, the donor, the helper who aids the hero, that should be always a guy who used to be, roam around with the hero, that hero friend or second hero. He can be anyone. The princess, I obviously rewarded the hero, rewarded for the hero and object of the villain schemes. Okay, fine. She can be anyone. She can be the heroine or the heroine's friend. What is her role in the movie? Her father, who reward the hero. Obviously, if there is a heroine in the movie, she used to have a dad or the character of a dad. Who used to reward her princess. He reward her daughter always. The dispatcher who sends the hero on his way. Okay, fine. He will be the story twist. So if he dies, imagine if a friend of mine, if a friend of a protagonist is dead, killed or being murdered by the protagonist, that's where the story starts. Okay, fine, you kill my friend and I'm going to take a revenge on it. So that's where the conflict opens. Fall zero means earlier, the beginning of the movie, we don't know the power of the hero. Okay, fine, he don't look like a guy who can solve problems, but then where it starts, once the conflict opens, the real hero inside him will come out. Here are some examples of narrative solutions: rescue, punishment, and departure. As usual, as I told you, the last thing, the end of the story or end of the film, what do? Either they'll save some good people or they'll give punishment to the antagonist, or they'll come up with the idea, okay, fine, this is the punishment for you. You are not supposed to do this, or you are supposed to be killed. So they'll kill the protagonist. So setup, as I told you, that this is the proper way of telling a story, the three-act structure involved in setup. First of all, the audience are introduced to the characters and locations. As I told you, the establishment shot of the movie and the characters of the establishment of characters, introducing the characters to the audience who is sitting in the theater. The second main characters talk about their spouse and their living lives together, which introduce them as a hypothetical characters. The second character is if there is a protagonist and he has a family, he used to have a characters like dad, mom, and relatives, some kind of. But the traditional way is they won't be there in the much scenes of the movie, but they used to play their we should have such characters in the movie. Conflict. The two main characters talk about what they will miss about their spouse within their locations and surroundings relating to them, discussing what they remember about them. A large majority of content in terms of films. Okay, conflicts. What is conflict? Basically, the problem. Or what is the main content? The heart of the story. Okay, fine. This is what is going to happen, or this is what the antagonist is doing. Somebody has to protest on it. So hero is there to protagonist is there to help or try to solve the problems. So basically, the conflict stands for problems. Resolution. As the name refers, resolution means the climax, the end of the story. We find about the car crash and the fact of two hypothetical characters were cheating on their spouse with each other, and one of them is died in the car crash. However, we don't see any visuals of car crash scene within the short film. Okay, here they talked about particular movie, and I'll explain how it happens. Example, open-ended movie. As I told you, the open-ended climax. Example movie is Aadukalam, Vetrimaran's Aadukalam. If you see the movie, those two main characters who actually played a vital role in the movie, they will move on from their problems, but we actually don't know where they actually going. We used to have some ideas, okay, they can be killed by them in another day, or they can they'll actually do some work and come up with they'll actually do some work and they'll improvise themselves in life. Or the closed ended movie is a normal, general, traditional way of telling a story. Okay, fine. This is the movie. These are the characters. This is the end of the movie. So that's how these three act structures or the narrative structures needs or demands the way of telling a story. Thank you, people.